people think of Michael Soulé, they usually think, I think, of his wonderful work as the founder of conservation biology, the work he's done scientifically on lizards and symmetry, and his work on mesopredator release and so on. But in the more than half a century I've known Michael, when I think back over it, I think of us getting drunk up at Norm Wessel's on the ridge, of us committing a crime for which the penalty is death in Rhodesia when we criticized the government, and generally a whole series of things like being shot at in a dump at Crested Butte when we were working with this sensible shoot. So we've had a great time, Michael, and I'm glad to see you're now maturing, and I want to wish you a great, great happy birthday and another 100 years. Take care.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine.
To his groundbreaking book, Conservation Biology, The Science of Scarcity and Diversity, Michael wrote, "There are probably conservation biologists who would be reluctant to lecture their students on how to love nature. In their defense, one could argue that loving nature is not a scientific subject, that ardor reveals subjectivity, and above all, that a biologist is not an expert on loving nature. This is rubbish. No one has more expertise on loving nature than the professional naturalist or manager who has spent his or her lifetime studying and admiring plants and animals. Thank you, Michael, for your wonderful words, for being a conservation biologist who wasn't afraid to teach me and so many others to love nature in all its complexity and to dedicate our lives to conserving wild things and wild places. Happy birthday, Michael."
May God's blessing keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May you stay. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong, and may you stay.
Kim and Lorraine here in Portal, Arizona. Sorry we couldn't be at your party, but I just wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you for being my mentor ever since I joined Wildlands Project a couple decades ago. And also thank you so much for coining the phrase that has driven my work and the work of the whole conservation movement ever since then, and that is networks of people protecting networks of land. May your connectivity dreams come true, Michael.
Happy birthday, Michael. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. Listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please. Don't fence me in. Don't fence me in. Jolie suggested that those of us who couldn't join you in Peonia might send a video that could describe some of the ways that your work has inspired our lives. I had to think a little bit because I knew it was more and deeper than groundbreaking science and big picture ideas, both of which are parts of your work that I care about a lot. But then I found this note that you wrote to Jim Estes and me when we were at the end of the manuscript of your collected papers. And I want to read that to you. Lately, I have realized that the essence of intrinsic value is love. When a person recognizes the intrinsic value of something outside of himself, he is identifying with that thing, understanding that it is not separate from himself and that he is intimately connected with this other. One might confess being in love with it. So when a person says that X has intrinsic value, she is saying that she is connected to it. She really sees it. The definition of a naturalist and even an ethical hunter is this seeing. And this is the basis of caring, protection, saving. Yes, this is woo-woo, but it's also true, I believe. This is what lies underneath my 1985 paper, What is Conservation Biology? Though I didn't see all the implications of it at the time I wrote. I believe this is how a true naturalist relates to nature, not through the frontal cortex, but through the limbic centers, at least milliseconds prior to it being interpreted by cognition. I love that, and to my ears, at least, it sounds uniquely you, the you that you share with the world through your writing and your teaching and your life. It sounds to me like wisdom that comes from deep, lived, reflected experience. Thank you so much for that.
Shower the people you love with love.
Yeah, shower.
Show them the way that you feel.
Oh, yeah.
Shower
yeah,
the
yeah.
people you love with love. Show them the way that you feel.
They say it never
shower
like
the people you love with love.
They say the
show
rain
them
must
the
fall.
Way that you feel.
Just like
shower
a pouring.
Michael, happy birthday. This is Reed, as you can probably tell. I must be quick, but I want to thank you, first of all, for being one of my most important mentors, as well as one of my best friends for many years. I really owe it to you that I had an entire career in conservation biology, a field that you founded, at least the modern field of conservation biology. And then from there, we, of course, had SCB, we had the Wildlands Project, and many great times. Sorry I can't be there. I'm not traveling much, but in this case I actually am traveling. I had a previous commitment to give a talk at a grasslands conference in Tennessee. Sorry I can't be there again, but take care. Keep it up. Bye.
Hey Michael, it's me, Lisa. Happy birthday. Well, one of the things you taught me was to watch my carbon footprint, so I feel just a little better about missing your party. I'm so sorry to not be there. But I decided to come to one of my favorite places here on Vancouver Island with Discovery Passage behind me to say that I hope you have a great celebration. There's so many ways you've influenced me over the years, but I gotta say, even now more than ever, you influence me every single day. You're the reason I really care about conservation and understand it. I'm so proud and honored to be a Wild Ways supporter. I'm honored to be a member of the Sinners Guild, and I'm also truly honored to be your friend forever. I love you, Michael. Happy 80th.
Yeah.
just wanted to say happy birthday, and that your books with Frankel and with Wilcox made a big impression on me before I even met you. I think the first time we met was in 1986 when Yulee Seal organized a symposium to convince Wyoming Game and Fish to capture all the black-footed ferrets, and you were the evening speaker at the dinner. I didn't really get to know you until I joined the Wildlands Project Board, and that was an impressive group of folks. I somewhat felt like a pretender in the pantheon there. But anyway, for the first 2 years, we worked together on committees and in board meetings, but it was pretty much just a business kind of relationship between us. And then somehow, after a couple years, we started to socialize and do things together. And at that point, we became friends. And I met a different Michael that I came to know and love. So while we continued to discuss important issues of conservation, we also started talking about things that friends talk about. And I just want to say that as for conservation, you always had a force behind your views, and it was always amazing to me how often you were right. Morality on nature is unwavering, and I again want to wish you a happy birthday, and I hope many more, because the earth needs people like you. Thanks. Take care. Bye.
Hello everyone else, I'm Scott Mills, and this is what first attracted me and brought me to Michael Soulé. This book came out as I was working as an intern at the National Wildlife Federation, having just come out of a master's program that insisted that if a person does conservation work, they can't possibly also do science. So that idea didn't seem to make much sense, and partly in response to that, I took this intern at the National Wildlife Federation in D.C. to figure out if that was true. But as I was there, this book of Michael's came out, and I read it from cover to cover and was entirely inspired by it, wrote Michael, asked him if I could be his PhD student, and he took me on. When I arrived to work with him as a PhD student in Ann Arbor in 1988, he was recently single. I was recently single. So we got to know each other by drinking together a lot. He would have his tequila on Friday nights, I would have my beers, and we'd talk about all kinds of crazy, outlandish ideas. Michael would talk about things like this idea he had to connect from the Yellowstone to the Yukon. Totally outrageous idea that probably would never happen, but we talked a whole lot about it on Friday nights. The fact that we both come from recent breakups may have been the source of the title of our first publication together.
Ooh, somewhere over the rainbow, way up high. Somewhere fly. And the dreams that you dream of, dreams really do come true. Someday you wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where you find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. And the...
That inspired me in so many ways, as he did for all of his students, to think big picture and to think about ways to bring together multiple ideas. He really emphasized a couple of big things. One is, he said that the more you can bring fields together, the bigger impact you'll have. And he correctly had his finger on the pulse of demography, genetics, field ecology, human dimensions as an important place to work. And this was an area that I enthusiastically embraced, and which really has carried me throughout my entire career. So, Michael, happy birthday. On behalf of your students, who appreciate beyond words all you've done for us as students, for the field of conservation biology, and for the planet.
Clouds are white and the brightness of day. I like the dark and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people passing by. I see friends shaking and singing, how do you do? They really say, I love you. I hear babies cry and I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than we'll know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like a lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where